learn all new things. Very good, very good. So you know what we are going to make today? We'll be making some new things with the help of balloons. Okay. See, yes, balloons only. Yes. That's, you heard me right. We will be making drawing, paintings and all with the help of balloon. Okay. So, you all are happy to listen this? Very good, very good. So, let's get started. Let's see what material we will be having. Before that, I'll just show you all the materials we will need. Okay, I'll show you what we are going to make. Okay, see, we will be making this caterpillar with the help of this balloon. Yes, this balloon only. Okay, and see, so beautiful painting with choo-choo colors. It's looking nice, na? Yes, I'll just show you how to make two colors together with the help of balloon and then how to make this painting. Okay, the balloons, yes. See, the flowers are looking so beautiful with two colors, na? So, I'll just show you how to make it. Don't worry, once you will learn, then you will see that how easy it is and how interesting and how lovely it is to make. Okay, so we will be making two things. First, we will go for little easy. Okay, okay, no problem. We will do this first. Okay, okay. And then we will do this. Okay, no worries. Okay. So, what we will need? I'll just go through that. Okay. So, we will need white sheet. Yes. White sheet is universal, dear. You always need it. Most of times we need the white sheet. Yeah. This time, if this is little bit not thick or thin, no problem. Will do. It's perfectly fine because not too much of color we are going to take. Okay, and we are going to use acrylic colors. So, they are little bit thick than the watercolors. Okay. So, I'm just keeping this aside and let's go for the material. Okay. So, this is the white sheet. Yes, one sheet for this and one sheet for caterpillar. So, two sheets we will be needing. Okay. Okay, then we will need acrylic colors. Okay, so I have taken pink and orange color. You can take any color, red and yellow, red and orange, or any of your choice. Well, whichever color you love to see in your flowers, you can take. Okay, then you have to take green color. Yes, I'll just show you. See, we need to make this type of grass and all, na? So that's why. So without this, how the flowers will look nice? So we will need green color. Whatever shade you have is perfectly fine. No worries. Okay. So we need green color. So this type of acrylic color we will need. Okay. We need 2-3 balloons. Yes, of any size. See, we just want to blow it so little. We want to blow it small, not big. So small balloon is also fine. Even if it is big, we will blow very small, okay? And I have a pump to blow the balloon little, okay? Then I have taken 2 bowls so that we can take out the color. We will pour the color in this bowl like this. We'll just take and pour it like this, okay? So, 2 colors, 2 bowls I have taken, okay? And we need a brush, okay? We don't need thin brush. We need just a thick brush. Okay. One brush is enough. This is just to show you. And a glass of water so that we can wash our brush. Okay. Else we don't need any water. Okay. So I hope you all are having this much, dear. Fine, fine. Very good. I can see, yes. Most of you all are having very good, very good. Okay. So, let's get started here. Just spread your sheet. And first, I'll give a just recap of the material, okay? See, I'm having white sheet, 2 balloons of any size, small, big, no worries. We want to blow it so small. We'll make a small balloon like this, okay? Then I have just got a pump to blow the balloon. If you want to blow it with your pump, you can do it, okay? I have a color palette of this. All these are all acrylic colors. Can you see? Fevicol acrylic color. Okay. Okay, and the rough kerchief so that we can wash our brush. Okay, yes. And this is the painting we are going to make. See this double color, I'll show you how to make. Okay. Okay. So let's get started. Just put the sheet on the workstation and get ready. Now today we don't need a thick sheet. If you have thick sheet, it's wonderful. But if you have thin sheet, then also it's perfectly fine. Because we are not going to cover full paper with the color. So it will not become soggy, and acrylic color as such are very good in thickness. So just not to worry. Okay. Okay. So just take the balloon, put it on your palm and blow it. We want small one. I think this is not correct. I'll take another one. See, I don't want a big one, okay? So I just put little air. I make it little small and put a knot on the top, okay? See, I just want a small balloon, that's all. So now the my balloon is ready. So just get ready with the balloon. Yes, we need at least two balloons. Okay, one will also do, no problem. If you want less color flowers, just take one. Okay. But if you want to make two color flowers, as such we will be making two color flowers, but that means two variation of flowers, then we will need two balloons. Okay, so I am just taking two balloons. One is ready and one again I am just putting the area. So see, I have just made small only, not too big. Can you see? The balloons are small, small only. We have not made two big balloons. Otherwise, you won't be able to make it, okay? So, the balloons are ready. Okay, so I'm waiting. Just get ready with the balloons. Tie a knot on the top. Yes. Can you see? I have just put the knot on the top. So that when you use them, the air won't go out from the balloon, okay? So I'm just keeping this aside. So children, till you get ready with the balloon, you can take any color balloon. We are not concerned with the color of the balloon. We are concerned with the color we will be taking in the bowl, okay? So any size, any color of balloon is perfectly fine. We just want the balloon, not the color of balloon is important, okay? So just get ready with the two balloons, blow it and put the knot. I'll just go up fast, recap of the material for the children who have joined late. Children, we need 2A4 size of sheets. This time, thickness is not a concern. You can take any, thick or thin is perfectly fine. Then, I have got ready two balloons. Yeah, small. Just put the air with the help of either this pump or whatever pump you have or with your mouth. You can just fill the air in the balloon and put the knot on both the sides. Then take two bowls. I have taken little color. I'll just show you how to take color. Don't worry. Okay. Then take just little water so that we can wash if our brush we want to do it. And we need acrylic color. I'll just show you. See, I have taken acrylic colors. Please children, don't take watercolors. Watercolor don't give such effect because we are using pour and balloon technique. Okay. So we will be using two colors at a time. And that's why we need acrylic color. Okay. So I think I'm clear with the material part and you all are ready with the balloon. So it's time we start our painting, okay? So now I'll show you how we will take two colors, okay? So this is the pink color I'm taking. Just open it and put little on a in your bowl. Just put, drop it little in your bowl like this, okay? And then take second color and just put near the first color. They will not mix up, just don't worry. Just put it like this and just put it here, just near the first color. Okay. Very good. And one more color we will be taking with yellow. Let's take red. Okay. So with red, I'm taking red. So I'll just show you how. See, this is the yellow. I'm just putting little bit of red on the, yes. Can you see? I just put on one side of the yellow color. You don't have to put it in the middle. You have to just put it on one side. Okay. So what you will be doing, you will be making few flowers with this color and few with this color. Okay, I'm waiting. See, just put one color, pour another color nearby. Don't put too much color. Take less. We don't want too much color, so just don't waste the color here. Take very little color so that we can use it in the painting. If you will take more color, so much color will be wasted. That's why. Okay. You can take any color, dear, of your choice. See, I have taken four colors. Pink and orange, yellow and red. So, our flowers will be few of these two colors and few of these two colors. So, we have ready two balloons with us. Can you see? So, first I'll take one color, one balloon and one ball of color. Okay. So, I'm just keeping this aside and we will start with this one. So, just look at me what I'm doing. Take your balloon and put in the middle of this color. See, just like this. Press it like this and just press it like this. See, you'll have such a beautiful image of two colors. That's why we had taken acrylic color, because this effect we get in acrylic color only. If we take watercolor, they mix in each other when we put side by side. See, when we pour this color, then they remain on its place only. But if you take watercolor, they will mix and you won't get such a beautiful effect, okay? So just dip it again. See, such a beautiful shade you are having. Just make these flowers randomly. Just dip your balloon like this and just press it like this. So you get two shades. See, can you see how beautiful the shades are looking? Just you have to press the balloon in the color first and then the paper. See, this is called pour and balloon painting because we pour the color in the bowl. We didn't mix it up. We just pour it little in the bowl. And then we use the balloon to make the painting. So it is called pour and balloon painting. Okay. So now this is the balloon I have used for this color. So I am just keeping this aside in one bowl. Okay. And now I am just taking the another balloon. Okay. So just dip it like this. Can you see? The red color is more. That's why we are getting less shade of yellow. So I remove the red color from it. Now we will be getting yellow more. Okay. See, just look at. So now we are getting yellow more. Because red color is so dark that it overpowers the yellow one. So now we are getting red and yellow. So can you see? So beautiful shade we have, isn't it? So you can take any color of your choice. We are having wonderful colors here. Okay, so just go with this type of two colors and make such round shape in the paper randomly. Yes, I'm just putting this aside because I'm done with this balloon part. Okay, so just do it. Yeah, you have to do this randomly. No hard and fast place that you have to do it. You just do it randomly all the sides. Very good. So you all are now doing so well. Very good. Yes, here you can take the shades of any of your choice. Perfectly fine, whatever shade you take. There is no hard and fast rule about which color you can take. You can take any two colors. If you take the color of flowers, it gives wonderful effect. Can you see? It's looking so fabulous. Very good. That's very nice, dear. Okay. So now what we will do? We will make the stems, the branches on which these flowers are attached. Okay. So I think you can take sketch pen for that, because if you do take color now, then it will be very difficult for you to manage. So I would suggest take any green color, whichever shade you have. See, I am having all four shades. You can take any shade of green color sketch pen you have. Because watercolor or acrylic color to make the stem will be very difficult for you to do. So just take any one color. I am just taking one color. Just go for any color. I would suggest that take green color, but of any shade. Okay. So now what we will be doing, we will be making lines. Just make a line like this downward. Below each and every flower, just make a line like this. We just want to show that all the flowers are attached to the stem, okay? So just do like this. Okay, I'm just waiting. Just finish this color. First finish this ball, balloon colors, and then take the green color. Okay. So I can see most of you have done with the balloon part. That's why I am telling you to take green color and make a randomly straight or little curved line to each of the flower downside. Standing like sort of like that. Okay, it should not be perfectly straight, but sort of similar line. Okay, so now what we will be doing, we will be making leaves. So just make few leaves type of like this near the stem. Just make few leaves like this. Just give a leaf like shape on all the stems. Wherever you find little space to make the leaves, just make them. See, I'm not giving any particular shape of the leaves. I'm just randomly making the shape of the leaves because we have made the bunch all over the page, na? That's why. So it will look nice with this type of leaves, okay? So just make randomly. So this will give a beautiful effect on your paper with this beautiful flowers. So can you see now all our flowers are having so beautiful leaves, okay? So now they are looking so beautiful, isn't it? So I made leaves all over. Okay, just do it. No hurry. Yes, just give a little bit shape of a leaf like. You don't need to make exactly any kind of sheet a leaf, okay? Just little shape roughly. Now what we will do, we will just take sketch pen only because this color is little wet. So if you will do another color, this will mix in this, okay? So I'm just taking sketch pen and just doing little black in between. So can you see? Yes, just do it with the black sketch pen. So it will be easy for you all to do it. So can you see now the flowers are looking so very nice, isn't it? Okay. Yes, just do it, dear. Right in the middle of the flower, na? You just have to use your black sketch pen. You can use marker also, no worries. Just use your sketch pen and do little because this is easy to manage. If you do take color or acrylic color, then again it will be difficult for you to manage because this color may be little wet in some places, not all, but some places are little wet because sometimes little more color comes on the balloon. So then if you will put the black color in the middle, it will all spread and make your flower black. That's why I have used black sketch pen. It is easy for you to manage then, okay? So now what we will do, we'll just make little grass downside, okay? So just do like this. Now this all effect I'm taking with this green color sketch pen only. I'm not taking the acrylic color because again the same thing, it's easy for you to manage with this sketch pen now. Because this thing we cannot do with the balloon. So this is just the side colors we are doing to give the impact of this painting, okay? So just do this rough like this, okay? You have to just scribble like this. If you have two shades, you can just take and give the effect of. I'm just scribbling, just making the hands up and down so that we get a nice grass effect, okay? You can take whichever shade you have, no hard and fast rule of that particular color. All green color are perfectly fine. Just little, just make like this, scribble like this, and we get a grass type of effect on the downside. So what does it look? It looks like there is a grass and the flowers are on the bed of the grass. So it gives a beautiful effect to the flowers you made with the help of balloon, okay? Very good. I can see you all are doing so well. That's nice, dear. Very good. Very good. Wonderful. Just do it with any green color, bacha. You can take any green color. Yes. So just, I've made all these branches, these stems, these leaves and grass, same all with green color, okay? I have not taken any other color except blue. The shades are a little bit different, otherwise all are green. So can you see it's looking so pretty, the flower bed, okay? So all the flowers with so beautiful shade, and the green color branches, okay? So now you can write your name also over here. So just write the name on the just downside of your painting. So those who are finished, just show me and then we will do another painting. Once you finish this, then we will be making with this. Yes, with the help of balloon only we will make this caterpillar, okay? Okay, so just finish this. Show me what you have done and we will be going to another. Okay, so I can see you all are done. Very good. So shall I keep this aside? Okay. So I'm just keeping this aside. And now we will be making this caterpillar. Okay. So again I am taking this sheet. So that's why I told you to take 2-3 sheets. Okay. So I have taken and just fold it from the middle lengthwise. I show you why. Okay. Now just open it. We don't need to cut it. Okay, so why we have folded? Because we want the middle part of the paper. Now we will make caterpillar like this. Just few circles up and down like this. So we get in the middle of the paper. That's all. So just take your paper, give a fold lengthwise. So we get a crease and then open it. We don't need to draw anything right now. We just want a crease of the middle paper so that we get a rough idea of the center of the paper. That's all. We don't want to draw anything right now. Okay, now I'm taking one bowl and just pouring the yellow color. Okay, now can you see? I'm just taking yellow color, little, not too much. And a drop, that's all. Okay. So now take the balloon and again the same way. See, this is the middle, huh? So I'm just putting little up to the middle part. So just press it like this and you get a beautiful circle with the red color, yellow color. So every time you have to dip, just press it and just near this make one another circle. You have to put this balloon in the color properly, otherwise you won't get nice color impact. Okay, so just dip it like this. Yes, I have not added any water, just do like this. We want little thickness, that's why dear. If you put water, then we don't get such a beautiful circle. So now I'm going little downward. See, this was little up, now I'm coming little down. That's why we made this center point. So we get a little rough idea where to go. See, again I am just dipping it and we just have to draw this balloon circles one by one, just touching each other. So now I am little bit down, okay? And the end is, I have taken in middle. So little up, little down, and then on the middle part, okay? So like this, just make the circles with the help of that balloon. Yes, dear, the shape can go anywhere. You can take first down, then up, or you can take straight. You can just go little curve. Any shape is perfectly fine. Not to worry about the shape. This is I have taken randomly. You can just move according to your choice. We just want to make circles one by one to give the shape of caterpillar. That's all. Yes, dip your balloon properly on the color. If you will not dip it properly, you won't get a perfect circle. See, I'll just show you. I'm just putting one drop so that. See, when you do this, now just do it like this properly. So that you get a full nice colored portion over here. And then you dip it like this, so you get a perfect circle. If you don't dip your balloon properly, then you don't get a perfect circle. So just do it. We have not added water because of that only. Because we want the perfect color to come on the paper. If you put water, then the water spreads and you don't get a perfect circle. Okay, so now what we will do, just make two standing lines on the first of your circle. So we are making the antennas of the caterpillar. Just make two standing lines, sort of small one. Okay, now make two eyes. Small dear, small, and you can just fill the half portion of the eyes, okay? Very good. And now make a face like this. Okay, so the face of our caterpillar is ready now. So can you see? Very good. Okay, so now what we will be doing? We will be making legs, okay? So you have to draw small opposite L. We make L like this, you have to make this side like this. Like this. On each and every circle, we will make two reverse L like this. I hope you can see dear. Just make two L's on the down side of your circles, okay? Yes, L is this side, na? So I'm making this side. So I have seen, can you see? I have drawn legs downside of every yellow circle. And what we will do, here we will make a small V type of things to give a little bit effect of the tail part sort of. So I think you all are ready. Yes, you have to make opposite L. Not the correct one L, opposite L, you make this side, na? You have to move on the left side. Yes. Left side. L when we do, reverse we do on the right side. You have to make a slipping line on the left side. So it becomes the legs of the caterpillar, okay? Now what we will do dear, we give the final effect, okay, little beautification of this. So we will be making little grass type of thing below this. So what we will do, we will make a straight line with green color like this. Just take the brush, little brush in your green color. And make a straight line like this, okay? Yes, randomly just make the straight line with the help of your brush only. No need of taking ruler, dear. We just want to randomly be taken, okay? So now, see, the caterpillar is up, na? So we want to show it. So what we will do, we'll just make grass till its legs, so that it will look like it is walking on the grass. Yes. So we will make the grass near the legs. Okay. So you just have to draw the grass part below the caterpillar. So what does it look like? As if this is grass and the caterpillar is walking on that grass. Yes. So now it's getting beautiful effect, isn't it? So beautiful it is looking, isn't it? Yes, you have to just draw straight line sort of with the help of brush. Okay. So just bring the lines down the legs. It should come, the line should come near the legs of the caterpillar. So we can show that it's walking on the grass part. The caterpillar is looking so happy, na? Can you see? We made smiling face. So it's looking so, so happy. Yes, yes. Just make like straight lines like this. Like this. Near the, come till up till the legs of the caterpillar. Yeah, just come till here. So it will give the effect that the caterpillar is walking on the grass like this, curve like. Caterpillar always walks like this. It never walks in the straight line, okay? And you should not forget to write your name. So, what we will do? We will just write your name in the corner of the painting, right down, right corner, okay? You can write with any color you have, black, green, yellow, whichever is with you or you are comfortable, just put your name. Yes, yes, yes. Just make the grass and waiting, okay? Very good. Just do it slowly, slowly. Just don't bring the grass right on the caterpillar. Just keep it down the legs. Very good. Very good. So now let's see what two things we made. Okay. So see, we made flowers and we made caterpillar. Okay. So two things we made. This is the flower, yeah, full bed of flowers, so many flowers, beautiful. So can you see, we made so beautiful painting of flowers, very good, and one caterpillar. So I would like everyone to show their paintings on the screen. As you finish, just show me both the paintings on the screen and we'll be very happy to see. Yes, very good, very good. Show me both the paintings, dear. I want to see both. Yes, I saw it in starting, but I want to see now together. That's wonderful. Okay. So those who have not finished, just get the work finished and show me. Yes, you all have done so nice job. That's very nice, beautiful, dear. Wonderful, wonderful, awesome. Yes, your caterpillar is moving so in curve. Very good, good, good. Yes, you made beautiful, bacha. Good job. That's very nice. Good, good, good. So I can see all of you had such a nice time and you enjoyed a lot, isn't it? Yes, with balloon, you had a nice time, you had a nice painting. And such a beautiful work you have done. Okay, I'm so very happy with all of you. Okay, children, So it's time to say bye, dear. Have a nice time. Have fun. We'll meet in another session, Sam, with new things, with wonderful things to learn, with new techniques. Okay, so till then, bye, dear. Okay.